Hello viewers, in this video lecture we are going to see the topic chained exceptions from the third unit of object-oriented programming. Objectives are to understand chained exceptions in Java, to apply chained exceptions in programming. Chained exceptions allows to relate one exception with another exception, that is, one exception describes the cause of another exception. For example, we can consider one example in which a method throws an arithmetic exception due to the error situation arrives in the divide by zero operation, but the actual cause of the exception was an input-output error which caused the divisor to be zero. So the method will throw only arithmetic exception to the caller, so the caller would not come to know about the actual cause of exception. So chained exceptions are used in these kind of situations to denote the actual cause of exceptions. There are, so to support the chained exceptions, the constructors of throwable class are used. Throwable class have two constructors with the two different parameters. First constructor is throwable class, where class is the exception that causes the current exception. Throwable string message throwable class. This is the second constructor, where the message is the exception message and class is the exception that causes the current exception. Now, there are some methods are there that will support the chained exceptions. First one is getCause method. This method returns actual cause of an exception. InitCause method. This method sets the cause for the calling exception. Now we can see the example program that will have the chained exceptions. First of all, we are having the class. Inside the class, we are defining one function. The name of the function is divide. Divide function having two parameters a and b, since it is going to perform the division operation in between a and b, and we are going to check the value of b. If b equal to 0, then we are defining one exception, arithmetic exception, with the object ae. We are defining the arithmetic exception as the top layer. Then we are calling the method initCause method, new IO exception cause. Then we are throwing the arithmetic exception with the object ae. So if b equal to 0, it will consider the, it leads to the handling of arithmetic exception. If else, if b is equal to b is not 0, then the division operation will be performed and the system will print the result of the division operation a divided by b. And inside the main function, we are calling the divide method under the try block. Okay, the divide method is called under the try block. In the divide method, we are supplying the parameter values for a and b as 5, 0. So definitely this would lead to the exception situation. So the first exception is the origin, the first arithmetic expression will be handled, and the cause of, previously we have defined the cause of the arithmetic exception was the IO exception. So that we have defined in the manner ae dot init cause of new IO exception cause. That means the cause of the arithmetic exception is input output exception, IO exception. So as per the parameter that we have supplied for our divide method, we have supplied 0 value to b, so that would lead to our arithmetic exception. And in the catch block, we are printing the two types of exceptions, that is the top layer exception and the cause of the exception, like system.out.println cause plus ae. Here the arithmetic caught means arithmetic actually denoted exception, arithmetic exception, and in the second printf statement we are printing actual cars. Actual cars is taken with the help of the method getCars, that is ae.getCars. getCars, the root exception is, our top level exception is ae, which is the object of the arithmetic exception. ae.getCars means it would take the cars exception, that is the io exception. So as a result of this program execution, we will get the statements like cart java.lang.arithmeticexception top layer, which is the exception taken referred by the object ae. Then in the second line we will get actual cars java.io.io exception, which is the cars of arithmetic exception. In this way we will get the output. So this is the structure of the chained exceptions. So in chained exceptions we will have the facility to mention the exception along with its root cause exception. So that's all about the chained exceptions. The possible university question is, explain chained exceptions in Java with example program.